don't do it to get very good at fighting with people. Although maybe sometimes it would be needed. But we do it because it's a kind of mind and body meditation. Combining the mind and the spirit with the body. And in fact, containing very many principles that we also use in theater, that the actor uses, to work with precision, to work with the balance, to work with using your spine in a particular way, to work with contradictions. You go one way to go another way. All the time breaking up the lines of the body, making a more dramatic picture. And we do it because very often now, we work on different projects. It's seldom that we can stay together for a long time. But this is something like you can put in your bag and take with you whenever you go. I'll do just a little bit more. This looks different, but it's quite similar. Halfway looks very different, but also it's about the work going on inside. Maybe you think that the work going on inside the actor is something very psychological, but here it's really the work with the energy passing inside, which is important. So it makes this internal work into something more tangible, more touchable. That's my personal training for the time being. But back to even more basics. If people come to us to work as actors, okay, many people come because they just did part in a little project, or their amateur theater group want to use us as pedagogues for their own work. Then maybe fine, we do something else. But if they come to us and say, I want to become an actor, then we introduce them to, among other things, we introduce them to this type of work, where we divide the body into different parts and study what the head can do, for example. So the head can do this. So the hips can do this. Okay. And each and every part of the body has specific elements. Now, these are you put in use in a type of work where you improvise the sequence, the rhythm, the directions in space. Sticking to each element, trying to go as far as you can with each and every one of them, but letting the whole body flow. So, in fact, it could be described with these words that you should not train. You should not train in the sense of acrobatics, or in the sense of dance, but in a work, in a type of work, which is
different from battle rehearsals, the actor should be confronted with the sea of creation. In my space, that would be a lot more. Okay, so if you look at that, it might look something even like this. Very quickly, maybe after 5 minutes, or maybe after 3 hours, or maybe the next day, no matter how precise you try to do it, it turns into something else. And what is left is maybe a sense of working with a connection between what's happening here and what's going on inside. So that each and every movement is connected from here to there. So it might be that we can make a little, I can make a little curve, starting with these exercises but ending up somewhere else, using the exercises as a basis. Okay. And again. And the word improvisation might take on another meaning. Not meaning something which is completely unprepared, but meaning a slow development. Slow, sometimes fast, sometimes slow, but anyway. Development, going from one place to another, going for something that you know, because you always know something. Because always when we work with new people that come to the States, they have something. They have a okay personality, but they have certain habits, way of walking that they maybe spend 20 or 25 years of practicing. And you can see this. And so we go from what we know and into the unknown. And if we get lost there, we come back and we go out again. Back and out again. And after a while, you are somewhere completely different. Because the basis of what the actor does is not, yeah, is the personal work. So, and when I work with this solo performance for love, there was always daily, it's kind of free work. In the sense that it was totally improvised. In the sense that you never knew what was going to be the beginning and the end, but with elements that were kept and built on from day to day. So I will try to make some kind of free work for you to see that.
impossible to repeat completely in that way. But there is always other reference. So there are different references to the work. Technical note. In the beginning, when we started using improvisation as material for performance, you have to be able to do it one more time. So you fix what you're doing completely, down to the very minute details of what the hand is doing. But with this work, we tried a different approach, giving name to the rhythm and dynamic of what you're doing. Say the rhythm and the dynamic is the principle, giving the essence of what this is about. And in this work, there's like five basic principles. Now they're not really anymore just dynamic rhythms. But we call them figures because they take on something more spiritual. So, but this is the basis, not to do very purely so that you can understand. The first one is called the title. The second one is called the sadhana. The third one is called nibbana, which means something like all wealth. The fourth one is called the schoolmaster. And the fifth one is called, just trying to lay the word. And each and every one has a specific way of using the spine, a specific attack, a specific way of putting the energy and the balance. But it's not so interesting, just these basic stuff, maybe. And actually, I don't think I ever do it purely. But, for example, with a tired one, I'll try to do a little bit, just working on that. But develop stretching stretching it as far as possible, okay? So maybe it's not so tired anymore, but that's the basis.
go on, I first have to go one step behind and say something about the voice. Now, maybe sometimes we work with specific techniques of the voice. But that was never really important to me. What was important was just a principle. The body first, voice afterwards. So, to send, project the voice out into space, it somehow has to have some support for the body, not only from here, but from here. So if you want to send the voice out, you must find, well, you must find some way of supporting the voice going in this direction, okay? But maybe, and that also means that it's more important to do precisely what you're supposed to do with the body and the voice can follow if you don't have any specific problem. So we don't work with trying to breathe in a special way, making very specific type of sound if we don't particularly want to use that in the performance. But instead, lately I've been working on letting the voice just follow its own path. Just trailing off by its own, like a kind of massage. Then it could sound something like this. Married. I never had a time when anyone could find it. What is it that? It is? Nothing.
good standard eye, not easy to live with. No matter, there are other things.
Since the day that we were married, we never had a towel where anyone could find it, and it is a fact. It is. Notwithstanding that I am not easy to live with, not my own judgment. But no matter!
understanding that I'm not easy to live with, not my own judgment, but no matter. There are other things. To kiss you is not to love you, not so simply.
Yes, my She's a wind in the trees. She's a stone at the bottom of the ocean. I hold her in my hand, but I cannot lift her. Can do nothing without her. Oh, Ella, I've nothing else on earth.
John. John.
Do you think that if two people
pass my days with little cheer, since I have parted from my dear. Oh, come home soon, I went to her.
Go fuck yourself,
is her answer. Now what is that for Christian word? I hope she feeds on dry goose turd. But still I love her, yes I do. I love her and her children too. I only think it fit that she had to quickly come right back to me. She smacks me down in a hurry, but I know, she says, I will not come after the bloody things you've done. Wait
till you two. I never loved a woman you. And never will it be that I'm not the woman in this party.
Thank you.
and if there is something you want to talk about or ask about.